Hey guys, in this episode, I'm going to show you how to make a flashy website.
Gigafied, it's a flash.
Flash
web. Yes, flash
not
website.
Flashy.
No, not flashy. Flash.
Oh man. So flash websites are extremely popular amongst web designers. What are you talking about? Flash is awesome! God, whether you hate Flash or love it, the point of this video is to showcase this amazingly free software from Adobe, because you used to have to shell out hundreds of bucks for their Flash software. But in a rare bout of generosity, Adobe created Project Roam, totally free software that lets you create PDF documents and Flash websites. So we'll be using it to make this website. Yeah, I know, it's reminiscent of a gaudy GeoCities site, but I'll be showing you the basics so that you can make a more awesomer-ist site. If you want to follow along, you can download all the project files from here. So, you can find Project Roam at the link below, and you can either download it or use it directly from within your browser. In the launch bar, choose Create New, Blank for Screen, Browser Size, Most Opted, or you can choose any of the other templates from the categories list. Now what we're looking at will be the first page of our site. It'll be the first of three, each of which will have basically the same background. So go ahead and on the left click the plus sign and select New Sheet twice to create two more sheets. Then select one of the pages. You should see a pencil button appear beside it. If you click it, you can change the name of the page. I named mine Home, About, and Contact. Since all three pages are basically going to look the same, we can create a master sheet with our design on it and assign it to all three sheets. To do this, go to View, Show Master Sheets. Then, if we click on the master sheet and edit it, the edits will filter to all of our other sheets. So let's start designing the base of our site by adding a background. If you just want to add a solid color, click the rectangle tool and draw a rectangle over the width of your canvas. Then you can use the paint bucket tool to add a gradient. Using the circles, you can adjust the direction and the color of the gradient. If you want to insert an image, go to Insert, File, and then select an image from your computer. With the arrow tool selected, you can resize it to fit the canvas. When you select an object, you'll notice a pencil button appear beside it, just like the sheets did. This will let you change that object's attributes. I'm going to add a blur filter and set it to a 10 by 10 pixel blur. This will take it out of focus. You can insert more pictures if you like using this same method. If you click on the text tool, you can give your page a title. Type out the text first and then click on the selection tool, select the text and click on the pencil button to change the font, color, transparency, and to add effects such as a glow effect. You'll notice in the left-hand menu you can see all the objects you imported. You can double-click on any of those objects in the list and relabel them. It's a good idea to give them a relevant name to keep things organized. The next step is to add navigation. If you want a simple menu, you can go to Insert, Interactive Components and choose a button or a button bar. But here's how you can create a more advanced menu. Import a diamond graphic for each of the three pages and remember to label them appropriately. Then using the text tool, write out the page name beside it. Then go to Insert, Interactive Components, Hotspot, and resize the hotspot over the Home button. Then click the pencil button and go to Advanced, Event Settings, Standard Events. This will add a new event selection to the menu. And under it, you can choose Click, Add Action, Go to Sheet, and under Go to Sheet, choose the first sheet. This tells it to go to the first page whenever the hotspot is clicked. But we can add other cool events too, such as animations whenever the mouse moves over the link. So to do this, click on the pencil button again, go to Events, Mouse Enter, Add Action, Set Property, and then under the Set Property option, click on Object and toggle down the master sheet and choose the home page diamond. And then for the property, select rotate and set the angle to 15. This rotates the diamond 15 degrees whenever the mouse moves over the hotspot. But now we need to rotate it back whenever the mouse exits the hotspot. So go to Events, Mouse Exit, Add Action, and Set Property. Select the homepage diamond again for the object, and then select Rotate again for the property. But this time, just leave it at zero. Continue this process of adding hotspots for the remaining menu items, linking them to the correct locations. Now you can test your page by clicking on the preview button at the top. When you mouse over each item, the diamond should move, but nothing seems to happen whenever you click on it. That's because we haven't added any content to our pages yet. So let's do that. Select the first page and draw a rectangle in the middle of the page using the rectangle tool, and set its opacity to about 50%. Using the tools that I've already explained, you can add images and text to give it content. If you want to add a video, you can go to Insert, Media Objects, Clipping Frame, and then double click inside the clipping frame and go to Insert, File, and select your video. Just note that the video has no controls and automatically starts playing. Then you can hit the back button to go back. To link to an external website, select a button and set the click event to go to URL, and then type in the URL for your site. And if you want it to open in a new window, type underscore blank for the target. Since most Flash websites have some type of introductory animation, the last step is to add an opening animation to our site. Now, we only want the first page to animate, so to make sure only the first page is affected, we need to make a copy of the master sheet by selecting it, going to Edit Copy and Edit Paste. Then rename that copy to Master Sheet 2. Then in the properties of the second and third sheets, change the master back to the new Master Sheet 2 that we just created. Now on to the animation. Select Master Sheet 1 and go to View, Show Timeline, and a timeline should appear at the bottom of the screen. Click on the stopwatch icon in the bottom left, and this will start animation mode. Then set everything that you want animated to its starting position. For instance, I want the title and menu items to fade in, so I'm going to set their opacity to 0 to start with. I'm also going to have the logo jump onto the screen, so I'm going to move it to the off-screen position first. Now in the timeline, move the position bar forward about 3 seconds and set the ending position for everything. Since you can't see the invisible objects, you can select them from the object menu and then set their opacities back to 100. Then move the logo back onto the screen. Now you can hit play to view it. You'll notice that you can still see the first page's content. So if you want, you can select the first page and set the content on it to fade in also. When you've tweaked it to perfection, save your work and then go to Output, Roam Website from the menu. Give it a name, set the background color, and choose a place to save it to. I'd recommend creating a new project folder and saving it there. Now all you have to do is upload the contents of that folder to your website and you're through. Right, well, that's because I've already done a video on that, and you can click here to view it. So depart from me now and go and create the website of your dreams. And send me a link, I'd love to see it. Alright, be sure to check out Tinkernut.com on Tumblr, Facebook, and Twitter. That's it for this tutorial. For more, go to Tinkernut.com.